Hey designers, if you are building out courses in Articulate Storyline and trying to figure out how users with the need to navigate by keyboards can use your courses, or users that are deaf and hard of hearing, or perhaps you have users that are blind and you're wondering how you can make your courses accessible for all of these people, stay tuned. I'm going to give you the quick and dirty on how to make your Storyline courses accessible, and I'm going to point you to further resources so you can really elevate your accessibility game. Stay tuned. I'm Lindsay, and I cover instructional design, e-learning development, and all things online teaching and learning. So when you're thinking about building out accessibility features in your Storyline course, the best time to start, of course, is going to be right from the start when you first begin building that Storyline course. It's always easier to start building an accessible course in the beginning rather than retrofitting later on. One of the reasons for that is because you can create accessible slides, duplicate those slides, and you know there are going to be at a minimum accessible as long as you keep those features intact. You can also make your master slides accessible as well, so that that'll have ripple effects for the best down the line so that your entire course is more likely to be accessible. If you're making your course accessible in Storyline, your goal should be keyboard navigable and usable with a screen reader. Now, the biggest challenge with Storyline is that it doesn't have an accessibility checker. You really need to use your own judgment on ensuring that your Storyline course is fully accessible. I do have a checklist that I will share with you. Just check the video notes and you can find a link to that. Now you might be wondering, what about templates? Can I just get an accessible template from somewhere, start building up my course and that, and then I'll be good to go? That's a good place to start. But the minute you start messing around in a template, and if you don't know what you're doing as far as accessibility, you're just going to start breaking those accessibility features. For instance, you start bringing in photos, animations, you're not adding alt text or making sure those animations are user-friendly for all users, you're going to run into problems really quickly. So it's really better to know what you're doing for accessibility, and then you can make your own templates and you know how not to break those templates and how to keep them accessible going forward. So in Storyline, there's a few things you have to do to make it accessible. If you are really, really, really needing to make something super accessible, I recommend Articulate Rise. It's a better, faster experience to make things accessible, but I know in Storyline there's so much more you can do as far as creativity, so it's nice to be able to use Storyline for your courses. And plus, you might have legacy courses and they're already in Storyline, there's nothing you can do. I get it, we'll make them accessible together. So of course, you need to have alt text for all your images. Something tricky about Storyline is that you need to have alt text for each state as well. So if you have an image or a shape with multiple states, and you have alt text on that base image or shape, you still need to add alt text to all those states as well. A core thing you need to think about when building out Storyline courses is that you need to set a focus order for keyboard users. That's the order in which a keyboard user is going to be able to navigate through the things on the screen. If you're using the built-in slide layouts in Storyline and you're not adding anything extra, you're generally good to go because the default focus order is going to be a good experience for the user. But the minute you start moving elements around or adding in your own or building things from scratch, you need to make sure that focus order, that's when you hit the tab and it goes through each element for selecting or for reading, you need to make sure that that is in order. And I'll show you how to do that in just a minute. As always, as with any e-learning, you need to give your learners control of the multimedia for playing, pausing, fast-forwarding, all of that. No surprises. They should be able to come to a slide, see that there's a video, hit play when they're ready to hit play. Of course, you need closed captions as well for those videos and any audio you have. And in Storyline, you need to avoid things, of course, that are not accessible. There's some features in Storyline that are not accessible. You can get a link to finding out what all of those are in that checklist I have in the video notes. So I'll go ahead and show you a course that I've built out in Storyline. This is fully published and hosted on my Google Cloud Storage. This is a demo course that is already accessible, and I've got a couple of things I'll show you on the back end to show you how I did make it accessible. First off, my hands are off the keyboard. My hands are off the mouse. I'm going to use just the keyboard to navigate using my tab button. So just hitting tab, you can see right away that Let's Go button appeared. That was the first thing that was selected, and then it moves on to volume, and then the settings there. So Shift Tab will take me back. I can use my return or enter button to select that and move on. All right, so you see there's a yellow border around this image here. Oops. Yellow border around that image. Hit, that means the whole slide is selected. Hit Tab again. And we can select that first name box. I can enter this with just my keyboard. Apparently I've got the caps locks on, that's okay. Tab over to submit, hit enter. It brings me to the next slide here. I can choose my avatar. Again, keyboard accessible, including the next button and the back button. And you see, I set up this order. I set up the tab button to go the next button first rather than the back button, because I'm assuming most people are going to want to go to the next slide right away. And I didn't choose my avatar. I'll go ahead and choose that one. And you can always change your mind if you don't want that one after all. Okay, so this Saguaro National Park course only has two sections, getting here and plants and animals. And again, keyboard accessible. So I'm gonna start with getting here. Can tab through really easily with just the keyboard. Tons of information here. If I have a screen reader, the screen reader will read the text on screen as well as the alt text for that map below. And every section here is keyboard accessible. This slide has a video, so if you hit the tab button, it'll select the video. I can hit the play button. Video of a cactus block. I can hit the space button and play the video, and I can move on. I can seek. I can choose all the options on the video player as well if I want to change the volume, enable closed captions, things like that. And then this slide is actually layers. These are accessible as well. I've got some special tips for you as far as making layers accessible. It's not as intuitive as you think it would be. It's a little tricky, but I can show you how to do that. Okay, so when you're looking to make your objects fully accessible, whether you have shapes or whether you have images, you always need to have an alt text set. If an image or a shape is purely decorative, you can go in and just make sure that the alt text is blank, and then a screen reader will skip it. But otherwise, you need to add alt text to all images, all shapes, and all states as well. So I've got a demo for you here of how to make your images have alt text. So you just right click, choose accessibility. You can see that object is visible is by default checked. So if something is just decorative, make sure you remove that alt text and you uncheck that as well. So for instance, that rectangle that you just saw, that item is just decorative. My users don't need to see it with a screen reader, but that image on the background of the hikers, we're always looking to provide an equivalent experience for people that are using screen readers, so that should have alt text. So just something to be really mindful of and really get in the practice of as you add media to a slide. The next thing you really need to know about is focus order. If you ever made a PowerPoint accessible, it has a really similar feature. It's like selection pane, where you make sure if someone's using a keyboard, all the elements are going to be selected in the order that makes sense, okay? So focus order is just the order in which keyboard users navigate using the tab button in Storyline. To set the focus order, you just head up to the home tab for each slide, select focus order. So here's a video demo on how to do that. Home tab, hit focus order. And for this slide, you can see each of my objects is already named. There's a default focus order and a custom focus order. So for this one, I want this to be custom because the default was out of order. And this is top down. The thing that's going to be selected first goes at the top, and then so on and so forth. And the reason I mention that is because if you use PowerPoint, the case can be a little bit different there. Now again, for focus order, you do have to do this for every single slide, which is one reason it's best to build an accessibility from the start, so you can build that into the master slide, for instance, and then you won't have to worry so much about each slide. You can just adjust that focus order as needed. Now what's a little funky is with layers. If your slide has layers, when you open up that focus order pane, it's going to include all of the objects from each layer as well as the base layer. Okay, so if you're trying to build something that's really fully accessible, it might behoove you to use separate slides instead of having a whole lot of layers. If you do use layers, keep it really simple. And here are the settings that you should use. So first off, you want to hide other slide layers. That's the visibility, so that there's not too much going on at the screen at once. And you also want to adjust the behavior. I really just love that it's constantly verifying things. That's great. You want the behavior to present as dialogue boxes. What the dialogue feature does for layers is it basically makes it impossible to choose anything else on screen when that dialogue layer is up front. That makes it a better experience for keyboard users. And you do want to pause the timeline of the base layer as well. Never forget to set the focus order, and you will make your life a lot easier when you set that focus order if you've named all your objects and images in advance in the timeline down below. So that's basically it. You can create accessible templates for yourself, but you do need to keep the basics of accessibility and storyline in mind to make sure that you don't accidentally break your own templates. If you share them with someone else, they need to know the basics as well so they don't break the templates. You can always test your own storyline project without even publishing it. On each slide, when you're in edit mode, you're going to start hitting that tab button and see in which order the elements are being selected and see if that makes sense. You can always publish it and test it further as well. It does require your judgment. Whenever you are doing accessibility in storyline, there's no accessibility checker. You do have to make sure you've covered all of your bases. So again, look for that checklist I've got for you in the show notes down below. If you really want to go further, you can always download a free screen reader. I can give you a link in the show notes to some suggestions on my website. You can try out a screen reader yourself, even if you don't regularly use one, and see how that course works out. Use the checklist I provided you and just keep practicing. If this is something that you're new to or you're relatively inexperienced with, it is something you have to remember to keep on doing, but it's very doable and it'll just become part of your workflow pretty naturally the more this is at the forefront of your mind and the more you are practicing it. If you're having trouble, let me know. I can help you out. I can offer coaching through my business, Lindsay O'Neill Consulting. I also have further resources on accessibility and articulate on my YouTube channel and elsewhere on my website. So let me know how I can help you. I hope this was helpful. Download that checklist in the show notes below the video, and happy developing.